Welcome to ATCM, the Emergency Medicine Channel. Now we are discussing about one of the two important differential diagnoses for acute loss of consciousness in emergency room. That is, one is syncope, another one is seizure. You all know that the definition of syncope is transient loss of consciousness because of the reduced perfusion to brain. So remember that it's a transient loss of consciousness. Patient falls, when he is standing, he can suddenly fall down. And the recovery is immediately after falling down, the cerebral circulation will be maintained as normal and patient will recover without any problem and there will not be any post-LOC confusion state. But whereas in seizure, it's an abnormal and excessive electrical activity from CNS and patient can have seizure-like activity, and especially in GTCS, patient can have loss of consciousness. And after regaining the consciousness, patient can have post-LOC confusion. So remember that in syncope, suddenly patient loses his consciousness. After falling down, he regains his consciousness and he'll have normal consciousness. There will not be any confusion. Whereas in seizure, patient suddenly loses consciousness. He'll have seizure activities and post-LOC, he'll have some confusion. Post-seizure confusion is very common. We'll see the differentiating features between seizure and syncope because it's a very common presentation to emergency room with acute loss of consciousness. Precipitating factors, there will not be any precipitating factors. Suddenly patient loses his consciousness. In syncope, patient can have a history of stress, emotional abnormalities, Valsalva maneuver, orthostatic hypotension, that's suddenly patient stand up from sitting posture, some previous cardiac diseases. Symptoms before onset, there may not be any symptom in seizure before, but syncope, you can have tiredness, nausea, vomiting sensation, visual problems, all these things. Posture at onset is very, very important. Syncope normally occurs only in standing posture, that too prolonged standing, but seizure can occur at any posture. Loss of consciousness is immediately after the symptom onset of the problem, but in syncope it takes few minutes. Duration of unconsciousness is many minutes in seizure, but seconds immediately after falling down, patient regains his consciousness. That is classical for syncope. Duration of tonic-clonic activity, it is mainly seen in seizure. It may not be seen in syncope, but very rarely you get some tonic-clonic activity, but normally it is not seen. Patient can have injuries after seizure, especially tongue injuries, but that is not seen in syncope. Facial appearance during the event, patient can have cyanosis, tongue bite, frothing from mouth, all these things are seen in seizure, but that may not be seen in syncope. Sometimes some patients can have some frothing from the mouth. Confusion and drowsiness after the convulsion, after the LOC, many patients regain his consciousness after a few minutes. But in seizure, even after that, patient can have confusion, post-ictal confusion. But that is not seen in syncope. Patient will be absolutely normal after the syncope. Muscle cramps are usually seen in seizure. It is not seen in syncope. Urinary incontinence is mostly seen in seizure, not seen in syncope. Headache is very, very common in seizure activity, but it is not at all seen in syncope patients. Very rarely migraine patients can have syncope or syncope-like features, they can have headache. An important investigation in seizure or syncope, you can differentiate in the emergency room by doing a lactate level. Normally, seizure activity is a muscle activity that increases the anaerobic metabolism. You can get an elevated lactate in GTCS, that is seizure, but it is not elevated in syncopal attack. Remember that two important things you should remember. One is post-ictal confusion. That is a classical feature for seizures. It is not seen in syncope. Immediate regaining of consciousness is classical for syncope. It may not be there in seizure. And one investigation, lab investigation, which can tell you that whether it is seizure or syncope, that is lactate level. Normally, lactates are elevated in GTCS, but it is normal in syncopal attack. So, we have discussed about two important differential diagnoses for acute loss of consciousness in emergency room, syncope and seizure. Thank you.